Thus far, we have considered the great romantic masters. More recently, we looked at the idea of program music, we looked at Berlioz's Symphony Fantastique. Today, we're going to look at the idea of nationalism in music. The 19th century was a time of nationalism. It was brought on by the Napoleonic Wars, and before that by the French Revolution. All of this forced each country to look within itself and to forge a clear national identity. Not all of the countries in Europe were unified at this time, and each country was now suddenly forced to unify itself politically, geographically, and also culturally. Composers and poets and authors looked back to their national folk legends, fairy tales, folk tunes. The peasants were the custodians of the ancient national culture, and so they looked at the melodies and the tunes of the peasants, and they believed that this would somehow create a clear national identity with which everybody could identify. And composers and music incorporated these old folk tunes into their compositions. They looked at the melodies which the peasants used and the rhythms, and they tried to imitate these particular features in their compositions. One of the great nationalist composers in Bohemia, which is today Czechoslovakia, was Smetana. Smetana was the first real nationalist composer in Bohemia. He was determined to establish a clear nationalist identity for Bohemian music. He lived during the time of the Austrian occupation of Bohemia, and he sought out some refuge in Sweden in 1856. He found the atmosphere stifling to his creativity with the Austrian occupation. However, by 1862, things had improved, and he returned to Prague. He went on a trip along St. John's Rapids, and he was on the River Moldau, which is the central river that runs through Prague, and he was inspired to compose a piece that depicted this nationalist sentiment, the pride of the Bohemian people. There were several scenes that he depicts throughout. The first scene, we look at the two springs which come together to form the river, the cold spring and the warm spring. Then there is the river theme, the famous theme. Then in the third scene, there is the forest hunt scene, in which we hear the horns and the trumpets proclaiming a hunting theme. In the fourth theme, we hear a peasant wedding theme with the national Bohemian dance, the polka. In the fifth scene, we see the moonlight nymphs dance, seeing the nymphs dance by the moonlight. In the sixth scene, we hear the river theme again. In the seventh scene, there is the rapids scene. We encounter the magnificent rapids along the river, and it's depicted by a grand orchestra, fortissimo, brass, and the whole orchestra. And then in the eighth scene, we have the widening of the river scene, when it widens out and flows into the Elbe. And finally, in the ninth scene, we reach the ancient fortress, the castle of Weißerode. This was an important place, Weißerode, which featured in the founding legend of Bohemia. Smetana used this idea of Weißerode in several of his works, and particularly in this one. This work, the Moldau, actually formed part of a symphonic poem of six movements, which was part of a broader work called My Vlast, My Country. So it was a deeply nationalistic work depicting his pride in his Bohemian heritage. And this was one of the movements which he composed in 1874, the Moldau. Smetana himself didn't have an easy life. And in fact, interestingly, he had just gone deaf just before he started working on the Moldau. And yet there is no trace of despair in the music. It is optimistic music. Sadly, towards the end of his life, he suffered from syphilis and he died in an asylum. But the music he left behind, this amongst many other works, was inspiring. It gave the Bohemian nation a sense of national pride. And we're going to look at the Moldau, a work which is much loved to this day, a beautiful work, an inspiring work.
Here you can hear the theme representing the two springs. The flutes play a semi-quaver figure together with the harp and pizzicato violins. The clavinets, marked piano, then join the running notes followed by the lower strings, also marked piano, whose running notes lead to the next scene. Here you can hear the river theme played by the violins with the running note accompaniment in the strings. Here you can hear the forest hunt theme, with hunting calls played by the French horns and trumpets marked forte, accompanied by running notes in the strings. Here you can hear the peasant wedding theme, which takes the form of a polka in the strings marked piano and with the addition of triangle strokes. Thank you. Here you can hear the moonlight dance of the water nymphs theme in the woodwinds marked pianissimo. Here you can hear the river theme in the violins with a running note accompaniment in the strings. Here you can hear the rapids theme, played fortissimo by a full orchestra. The brasses and percussion capture the grandeur of the scene. Here you can hear the theme representing the river at its widest point, the Foot Orchestra plays the river theme, Fortissimo, in a major key with a faster tempo. Here you can hear the theme depicting Weisserath, the ancient castle. The brasses and woodwinds play a hymn-like melody fortissimo with cymbal crashes.